Associate Professor Maki Koyama conducts research on human behavior and casualties during natural disasters and on social implementation of disaster countermeasures based on local issues. Today, she will explain disaster prevention and disaster control measures in natural disasters during COVID-19 pandemic.
The most important thing in natural disaster countermeasures is fatality prevention. For example, earthquakes can strike suddenly, so it is important not to live in a house or infrastructure that is insufficiently prepared to withstand a certain level of earthquake force. On the other hand, immediate evacuation from areas that are generally prone to flooding or landslide is important before a disaster occurs, taking into account the weather conditions. Based on the disaster susceptibility information obtained from the flood and landslide hazard map in your area, you can determine whether or not to seek a safer shelter other than where you live in the event of flooding or landslide. Measures to prevent the risk of contact and spread of COVID-19 include the avoidance of 3C, closed spaces with poor ventilation, crowded places with many people nearby, and close-contact settings such as close-range conversations. However, number of public shelters are limited, and there is likely to be a congested. It is a big challenge for the 3C measures at shelters in time of COVID-19 pandemic. In this context, it is thus important to consider the concept of dispersing evacuation in barrier sites other than in public shelters. In other words, people are not only confined to evacuating to public evacuation shelters, but should also seek refuge in homes of relatives and friends, hotels, safe upper floors, shelter-associated parking lots, and other places where they can stay safely with less risk of flooding or landslides. If this can be achieved, the number of evacuee congested places can be reduced, and the risk of the spread of COVID-19 can be mitigated to some extent. Furthermore, an important aspect of running a shelter is zoning, which limits the impact of infected evacuees by completely dividing both space and people. However, depending on the specific evacuation site, complete zoning may be difficult to achieve, such as evacuating to a large hall or a gymnasium. In this case, approaches such as dividing a shelter space into large blocks to keep sleeping areas by at least 1 meter or, if possible, more than 2 meters apart, or creating at least a 2 meter high partition between each bed. It is also important to keep entrance open and well ventilated, and to monitor daily the temperature and physical condition of evacuees so that preventive actions can be taken, if necessary. In the event of a natural disaster during the COVID-19 pandemic, not only will more people be inclined more than ever to seek shelter at home after a disaster, but also evacuation sites and life under evacuation are expected to become more diversified. People are more inclined to self-isolate during the pandemic. And even those who have been able to live independently are more likely to fall into a state of social destitution. Therefore, there is a likelihood that issues that in normal circumstances may have been left unattended as problems of some people who need support will emerge as problems that can happen to everyone, thus providing the possibility to initiate certain countermeasures. We live in an era where it is imperative to personally think and responsibility address social inclusion as a social issue. Disaster preventive measures taken by local residents are crucial in order to reduce the death toll from natural disasters. In the past, however, several instances where failure by local residents to take appropriate measures have resulted in casualties. In recent years, the importance of evidence-based policymaking, EBPM, has been recognized, and introducing EBPM to community disaster risk reduction has been gaining ground. Gifu Prefecture and Gifu University have jointly established the Gifu Disaster Mitigation Center with the effort to incorporate and advance EBPM into community disaster risk reduction. In the face of the current COVID-19 pandemic, we believe that it is important to develop human resources who can take the lead in implementing evidence-based community disaster prevention activities.